protests we are seeing across the country were sparked by the death of George Floyd, but they are about so much more. The deep-rooted inequality we have seen in this country for centuries, and specifically the tinderbox over the past 8 weeks as the coronavirus shook our nation and shut us down. Jeanine Cook saw firsthand. Jeanine opened Harriet's bookstore, named after Harriet Tubman, just a few months ago. And now, without any support from the government, she is struggling to keep her business afloat. Jeanine, you opened your bookstore February 1st. It was not 2 weeks later that the same place orders began. Tell us your story.
Yeah, I mean, you know, Harriet's Bookshop is designed to make sure that people have a place to celebrate women authors, women artists, women activists. That's what's important to us. And now you see how vital that type of bookshop is, because that is exactly what has been necessary and needed in our society as we speak.
The government stepped in. They put small business loans, PPP, in place. They said it should impact all businesses. It didn't help yours.
That's okay. Yeah, it hasn't helped us because we had just opened. We didn't really have, like, a big staff. Like, we don't fit any of those eligibility requirement things. But what we did have is the support of the people, and that's what we continue to have. People from all across the nation have stepped in to buy books from Harriet's Bookshop. They have sent support, sent love, tweeted, shared, you know, everything.
In the last week, since the protests began, do you believe your story has been told and there is support for Black-owned businesses like yours?
Yeah, I believe that this is the only way that we'll continue, is to make sure that we have support for businesses like ours. Because women-owned, Black-owned, women-owned businesses are what's going to help lead this thing in the future. Yeah, very much so.
Well, what's helping you right now, while it's national, is a grassroots effort. Do you believe that minority-owned businesses are on the same playing field as the rest of the business environment?
I think that we have to make a decision to be on as many planes as we could possibly be on, right? And I think that right now, if there are things that are cutting us off from this side, we got to get creative and approach it from another side. But what's really helpful is that the people are with us. The people are with small businesses, especially small businesses like ours.
But as far as information available to you, when it came time to figure out what aid was there, do you feel like the government
to
educate you?
No, I mean, no, not at all. I don't think that businesses like mine were taken into account. I think that I had to call city council myself. I think I had to call, you know, I had to call support in, because who was going to support us? Like, no one was coming to my door and knocking at our door saying, hey, this is how you do this work.
What did you do over the last week when these protests occurred? You can't afford to have your store looted.
Yeah, and not only was our store not looted, we didn't board up our windows. We didn't do any of that. I believed really strongly that the people in this community were going to take care of Harriet's Bookshop, and they did. They understood that we're a resource and that we're necessary if we're going to continue to actually organize and be an organized function and body and fight against some of this injustice. Guess what? We're going to have to do that together. We're going to need education. We're going to need books.
Your phone's ringing. I'm really looking to order a book, but you weren't even here this week.
Yeah.
You were in Minneapolis. What was that
like? Yeah, so, I mean, we've been all over, right? We've been all over Philly. We've been giving out books. But then we also went over to Minneapolis to pay our homage to George Floyd and the family of George Floyd and the community of George Floyd, and also to give books out, right? We had a donor that supported us with being able to give out free copies of Harriet Tubman's autobiography, Malcolm X's autobiography. And that's how we've been able to, you know, continue to do what it is that we've been doing. We've been giving out books in Minneapolis, here in Philadelphia, and we're going to continue.
How did you protect your store here if you weren't even in town?
We had folks in the community that actually, I'm in Fishtown, which is like, you know, there were bat-wielding folks down there. There were people that were sending racial slurs down in Fishtown. But there were also people from the community that stood right in front of our bookshop and said, like, no more, right? It won't happen here. As did I. I slept at the bookshop several nights this week to make sure that, you know, our presence was known.
Jeanine, thank you so much for joining me.
Of course.
Best of luck to you.
Thank you.
I want to bring a man who wants